My goal today is to build a story illustrator bot in ChatGPT that will create multiple consistent characters for your story.
So once you're set on your story character details, you can start asking the illustrator bot to put them in the environment and the context without repeating tedious prompts each time. And you can discuss with it to how to better structure the composition and fine-tune your images with natural languages. I will also share with you my ultimate hack of achieving character consistency. Finally, you can have an illustrator that actually understands the story, so it will create images that present the best details possible to match your narratives. So let's get started.
The process of image generation of this GPT is that when the user sends in the request, the GPT bot will then take into the consideration of the configuration and the instruction you have at the GPT backend, and then generate a prompt of under 400 character limit or about that range to DALL-E, and then DALL-E will generate an image as the output. And now, as I tested, the GPT would not use GenID and C number in its image prompt to DALL-E to generate images. So what you input as instruction into the GPT is the only thing that you can control. If you want to know about the SQL rules that OpenAI used to prompt ChatGPT with DALL-E, you can find the details in the notes in the description below. Setting up your character design and art style is the most important step when creating this GPT bot. You can ask ChatGPT to give you suggestions of the character designs, but I have my main character design for my new storybook that I created myself, and I wouldn't want to let ChatGPT to take away all the fun of story design. My first character is Yoko. She is 8-year-old, Japanese girl, dark shoulder length hair with brown eyes. You want to set the age because if you don't, then it would probably give you some full-grown woman when generating the image. And for the outfit, I got a purple hairband with a bow, sleeveless purple dress over white t-shirt, and brown Mary Jane shoes with white socks. I wanted to look as distinct as possible, and the best way, I think, to do this is with your outfit. That's why I specify very specifically how she should look in terms of outfit. I also have markers, and to test, I also have an animal, Lucky. To maintain the consistency of animals, I would recommend to specify an easy identifiable dog breed. So a simple word like corgi has embodies a lot of characteristics that you would know. And I also recommend to have dog features with less uneven markings, such as spots or colors, to decrease the failure rate of different results. When you design these characters, you want to get as specific as possible with the important features, but at the same time, you want to use as fewer words to describe them as possible, because when the GPT sends instructions to DALL-E, it will only include less than 400 character long of prompts, and the more the characters of the prompt, the more they will confuse DALL-E and create horror images. But don't worry, some of the details lost can be easily corrected after the images are created. I will show you later in the step. Also, it's important to determine the art style so we can get a more consistent look and feel of the images. For me, I am using 3D Pixar animation style, as I know this is the style that it has been trained extensively on. And also, I love Pixar. If you want to find your own unique style, you can check out a super helpful resource I found online that can teach you how to get the most out of DALL-E and the art styles that it was trained on. Click on the notes of the video link in my description below to get the DALL-E prompt book guide if you want to dive deeper. And you will find a lot of styles it was trained on in this document. After setting up the character design and the art style, let's get into the building of the GPT bot. Let's build the bot.
So let's go to ChatGPT, go to Explore, under My GPT, create a GPT.
You can build a bot by talking to it and telling it what you want, but it requires a lot of back and forth. And when you place your various requests, it sometimes would wipe out the previous request.
Chat with it to let it know what you like. I find it faster to just go to configure to input your own information. So add the name story illustrator and description if you want to,
And also input the instruction here. This is the instruction the bot builder created after our chat. So I prefer to have an instruction written out in a separate place and copy paste. This instruction is from multiple back and forth chatting session with a GPT builder to get the best instruction I think is suitable for my needs. You can take it as a reference or adapt it to your own. And I will share this in the notes in the description below. Okay, so copy and paste. I will quickly walk you through what I got here in my instruction. First is the purpose of the bot and a brief mention of the backstory. And second, this is an important instruction of how it should behave. So in here, I said, using established character description and base prompts, the GPT ensures consistency in their appearances, outfits, and expression across illustrations. Each illustration request will center on the specific scene's context. Whenever GPT generates an image, it will always maintain a consistent visual style and use the base prompts for subject description. For every image generated, the GPT will ensure high resolution and high quality Pixar 3D animated film style, and the character should be depicted with the same visual style, proportions, and closing details as the reference images unless specifically requested by a user. The GPT will not alter the said outfits and features of the characters. Always generate the image in aspect ratio 16:9. This is because I want to make a movie out of the images. So in here, I said I wanted to follow a formula when you create the image prompt, a specific formula that will be used for creating prompts for DALL-E. The first element I want is the subject description. I wanted to utilize the base prompts below for the characters. All character description in the base image prompts below for each character must be fully included in every image prompt. An environment description will be included, and it will detail the scene setting based on user requests or generate an appropriate background if not specified. And art style, I wanted to consistently using Pixar 3D animation style. And for color and light, I wanted to describe the main colors and lighting. I also asked it to always include the camera angle and composition to indicate the perspective for the scenes. For the reference image usage, as I mentioned, I don't know how much it will affect things, but I still include this as per the GPT builder suggestion. So I just include this just in case. And the base images prompt for each characters, as I have shown you. After adjusting the instruction, come down to knowledge, and you can upload files here for any other information you wanted to know. Here, I would actually include the images I have. How do I come up with these images? After you have the instruction here, you can go back to create, and maybe you can even save it and start chatting with it and ask the GPT builder to create some samples for you. For the capabilities section, you want to click all three of them so it would be able to search online and use DALL-E. And for co-interpreter, you want to sometimes upload your own reference images directly at the chatbot so it can refer to it and maybe create something similar. And for action, we don't need to do it for this particular chatbot, so we can just leave it. And I don't really like this image, so I'm going to click it and upload my own image. This publish to only me and confirm. The first time to test it, I would actually come back to explore and to edit the bot, because then if anything goes wrong, we can directly chat with it here to correct. So let's ask it to generate a group picture. And here's the first image it gave me. And first, I can see that it is not generated in the aspect ratio of 16:9. And also, it generated two lucky, which is actually pretty normal when DALL-E generates image of multiple characters. But I'll show you how to correct this. I first would like to ask it to generate always in 16:9. So you can see that even if in the instructions, sometimes it doesn't read everything in there. Technically, the things that you put in the instructions after you save, it should always take that into consideration, but sometimes it just doesn't. I don't know why. That's why you need to come here to correct this sometimes and to make sure everything is good. So it says that it has updated it. I want to check by going to configure and instruction and see what it changed. After I update the 16:9 ratio, it removed the base ROM. So I will have to add it back. So always check back to the instructions to see if it has removed any important thing before you save. That's why I also said to have a separate document to include all the details, so it doesn't do anything like this and you lose the details of your other information. Copy. My computer is super slow. Okay, and read through it and make sure everything is good and close. Go back to create and let's test again. An image of the number 3 laying wood. Well, it's really weird. Come to create, scroll down. I probably accidentally clicked this, so it generated an image on the right. So it does give me a 16:9 now. But as you can see, the details of the characters are not all correct. For example, the shirt should be all plain yellow. And also, Yoko should have a white shirt like this one. But something like this, or even like this, is easily correctable. And I will teach you how to do it. So let's download this, and let's save. And publish to only me and confirm. The first image I asked it to generate gave me 2 dogs. But this is actually correctable. I will show you how to do it later. And then I test to see if can create something more action, like chasing a train. The first image it gave me is not really the style I'm looking for, so I'm going to ignore it. And the second one, somehow it generates a 4th character. And then Marcus doesn't really look like him on the side. Yes, sometimes like something like this happens. If it's too hard to correct, we'll just ignore it and try it again. Like, I think this one is pretty similar to what I'm looking for. I really like this one. And then I try to upload a reference image from up and trying to ask it to generate the same thing. The first time it gave me an error, but the second time it gave me something like this. I think it get the gist. I had to generate again, and this time the character of Marcus is not right. So I tried again. This one I don't like, even worse. And I tried to ask for the gen ID. This is the process. You just have to try again and again. And then I upload another image from up to recreate the same image. It gave me this one. And the actual dog that is easily correctable and this weird detail. I try to use the image from Soul as a reference. I think it completely captured the emotion and expression from the reference image. And then I ask it to do one with Marcus. So overall, I can say that this bot is definitely not perfect. But there are just a lot of things you can do with it. With the capabilities of uploading your reference image and assigning the details of each character and putting them all in the same environment. With that said, I'm going to teach you how to correct the wrong details that it generated. The easiest way to correct the detail is to use Canvas Plus. You first upload your design, use in a new design. Custom size, generate new design. Click on the image, click edit photo. The Magic Studio will show on the left side. Click Magic Eraser. Adjust the brush size and simply just paint over the unwanted parts. Another thing I want to adjust on this image is I want Yoko to wear a skirt. Go to Magic Edit so we can adjust the brush size and brush over the part that we don't want, and then hit continue, describe. I would put skirt in here and generate. It would then generate 4 results for you to choose from. If you don't like any of them, just click generate new results, select the one that you like and click done. To save, click share and click download. Choose the file type. adjust the size and other details. Download, and now you have an image that you can use.
I hope what I share with you today is helpful for you. If you want to see how to turn these images into animation, watch the next video here, and I will walk you through with a step-by-step process. I will see you there.